हाय डियर फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू? दिस इज तरिकुल इस्लाम कम्स अगेन विद ए न्यू एपिसोड ऑफ माय कंटिन्यूअस पेरेंटिंग सीरीज एंड टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट इश्यू दैट इज एंगेज योर बेबी विद सम एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलम एक्टिविटीज फ्रॉम देयर अर्ली एज. यू नो दैट आई ट्राई टू कंडक्ट दिस वीडियो सीरीज इन द टाइटल a parenting series where I discuss different issues, different aspects and different terms related with parenting care for this time. We know that parenting is a very important thing that changes day by day, time to time. So we should also change the techniques of parenting caring due to change of technology, due to change of society and due to different findings of researches. So I always try to link the recent findings related with parenting. Today our topic is extracurricular activities. We know that extracurricular activities are treated as the creativity and extra ability of human being. But we don't know what is the perfect time, what is the high time to engage or to motivate the child to do some extracurricular activities. In this point, many parents do a lot of mistakes. They have many wrong concepts, misconceptions about extracurricular activities. That some parents think that if their child join with some extracurricular activities, be engaged with some creative works, it will hamper their study. But it is totally wrong. You will find a lot of meritorious students there whose results are extraordinary. They are also engaged with a lot of extracurricular activities in their school, college, as well as in some other organizations. So extracurricular activities never create any hamper. But if it is a sole business that the children engage with it, avoiding their regular study, then it can create hamper in their study. That's why a well-recognized scientist and teacher, Professor Dr. Jafar Iqbal always like to say that the extracurricular activity has value zero and the study, regular study, textbook study has zero value one. So if you put a lot of zero in front of after of one, then it will add some value. Like if you have one extracurricular activities and you also continue your study perfectly, then it will 10. If you have two extracurricular activity, it will, the value will be 100. And if you have three extracurricular activity simultaneously with completing your regular study, then its value will be 1000. And when you will increase your extracurricular activities, the value will also increase. But you look that if there was no one, then how many extracurricular activities, how many zero figure you have doesn't matter. Because 10 value is zero, thousands value zero, value also zero. So without regular work, without regular study, academic study, there is no value of extracurricular activities. At first, the children have to complete their regular work, regular study, academic study. Then they will be engaged with extracurricular activities. And you will confirm, you will clear this issue to them. Otherwise, they will not be concerned about this issue. So extracurricular activities is very important to build, to enhance the personality, the creativity and the potentiality of a human being. But what type of extracurricular activity should be engaged with? Today I will discuss only the extracurricular activities that can be involved the children aged from 1 to 5. And on next video, I will discuss the other extracurricular activities for that they may be engaged later after when they are above 5 years old. So today I will discussing the very early age, from their early life, what extracurricular activities they will be involved. First of all, you have to teach them some poetry, some rhymes, and you have to teach them to recite this poetry. It will very much beneficial for your baby, for both to build their confidence as a presenter, as well as it will create fluency on their speaking or presentation. Because when they will recite a poetry or rhyme in front of some people perfectly, then their motivation, their inspiration will be developed, and they will be able to perform anything later in front of people. And the second important thing is poetry, rhyme, and any other recitation has some rules, has some grammars that create fluency on your baby's speaking ability perfectly, and their pronunciation will be corrected. It is very much important at the early age. So first of all, you will teach them how to recite rhymes or poetry in front of people. The second important thing is the another extracurricular activities you may teach them, that is speaking something that is called instant lecture. You will give some topics to them and you will ask them to say something in front of some people. It may be happened in the family meeting, or it also may be happened in the academic area, like where they are in play level or KG 1, 2, 3 or any other classes. They will be able to speak something in front of his classmates, his teachers, and it will increase his knowledge as well as his confidence. And the third important extracurricular activities that you may teach them, that is Scout or Rotary or Red Crescent, Red Cross, any other voluntary work. Whenever you will have any chance to engage them with some voluntary works, you will motivate them and you will ask them to join with it. Because when they will do some voluntary job, it will affect positively in their minds in two ways. First of all, when they will do this type of a voluntary job, their communication skill will be developed. Because when they do the Scout, Rotary or blood collection or any other Red Crescent, Red Cross and many other voluntary works in our society, and a lot of NGOs provide facilities, offer facilities for child to do voluntary job. When they will be engaged with this voluntary job, their communication skill will be increased, because they have to interact with a lot of new people and have to solve some problems. They will learn how to solve problems and it will build their confidence level also. So these two important things, confidence and the that I have mentioned earlier, the communication skill, these two important things will be developed. And when this characteristics is developed on your baby's mind, baby's attitude, baby's personality, then they will become a leader and they will become to handle any situation that they faces. So today I will finish my video. I just wanted to give some instructions to you about how you may you encourage your baby to do some extraordinary extracurricular activities. There are a lot of options you will find around you, in front of you, that you may let them engage with. So I will just give three examples to as a guideline. You may choose any other thing, but you have to be confirmed that it will add some value, and it will not hamper his personality, his study, his attitude and his socialization. If you be concerned about these two things, that value addition and not any negative impact, then you may encourage them to do this extracurricular activities, and I hope it will be very much beneficial for your baby. And it is also a important topics, a important part of parenting. So thank you very much. Today I will finish my video. I will come again tomorrow with the part 2 of this extracurricular activities, that the babies after 5 years may be engaged with different types of extracurricular activities.